The India of the last 30 years, gigantic water transfers are taking place. Gigantic water transfers are taking place. They're taking place from village to city. They're taking place from agriculture to industry. Within agriculture, they are taking place from food crop to cash crop. Tamil Nadu, poor people in summer, what do they drink? Kool, ragi. Once vast areas of the dry lands of Tamil Nadu had ragi, had millets. They've died. Anantapur used to be 65% millets. It's died. They're growing. Please do not understand the water crisis as an issue, as only an issue between Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. That is not the case. Okay? It is not the case. What you are looking at is a mega water. By the way, Mandya district of Karnataka, 50% irrigation, having a severe water crisis. In a capitalist economy, the nature and use of water use has changed dramatically in the last 30 years. Do you know the number of per capita availability of water per Indian in 10 years fell by 300 cubic meters? Wow. It is, you are looking at hell. Please don't just look at Karnataka as hell. Hell is here also. It serves entirely the purpose of the ruling class to have Tamilians and Kannadigas kill each other. It isn't so simple. There is a gigantic water crisis that is arising, and let me tell you how much it is rooted in Tamil Nadu also. In the last 30 years, 50 years, but particularly in the last 30 years, what I don't use the word drought for this place. I use the word mega water crisis. Because it's my, well, when we say drought, what do we mean? We mean rainfall. Drought refers to meteorological failure. I don't refer to, we have in Tamil Nadu, my dear, we have groundwater depletion. We have hydrological drought. We have agricultural drought. We have meteorological drought. It is meeting into a mega water crisis, and we are only concerned with Kaveri. Also, another thing, the river is not an endless source of water. Every river barring one or two in the country are showing a serious fall in the level of water that they have. Whether Narmada, whether Kaveri, whether Godavari. Last year, for the first time in 140 years, the Godavari went dry at the source. The Krishna River went dry at the source. Now, what do non-capitalist journalists do? My friend Jaideep Hardikar and I, we traveled to the source of seven rivers to see why they have gone dry. Many, many things happened. In the India of the last 30 years, gigantic water transfers are taking place. Gigantic water transfers are taking place. They're taking place from village to city. They're taking place from agriculture to industry. Within agriculture, they're taking place from food crop to cash crop. 1 acre of sugarcane. 1 acre of sugarcane takes 18 million liters of water. 1 acre of jowar takes 1.8 million liters of water. In the water you use, it is the figure, you will find it in terms of acre inches. If you go to the agriculture department's website, it will tell you how many acre inches acre is taking. 180 acres is 18 million liters. And that is not, I'm not counting yet what the mills are using for processing. That is another source of water. In 1 acre that you grow on sugarcane, you can grow 12 acres of bajra, 10 acres of jowar.
Jowar is wheat. Jowar is wheat.
Chola.
And Bajra?
Kambu. Thank you. I mean, I didn't know it was kambu. So, you see, in many areas where we used to grow, even today in South Tamil Nadu, poor people in summer, what do they drink? Kool, ragi. Once vast areas of the dry lands of Tamil Nadu had ragi, had millets. They've died. Anantapur used to be 65% millets. It's died. They're growing groundnut, cash crop. 10 times, 20 times the water that ragi takes, groundnut takes. So we have done something in the gigantic policy shift in the liberalization period when we encouraged millions of poor peasants to shift to cash crop. It was happening earlier, but it happened on a gigantic scale in the last 25, 30 years. So you have a water problem coming from what we are growing. Then there are also gigantic shifts from livelihoods to lifestyle. Do you know that RTI in Maharashtra showed us that the cities and towns are getting 400% more water than the villages in drinking water. Now, where is the water coming from? It's coming from the villages. Where are the rivers? Where are the lakes? They're all in the countryside. I live in Bandra in Mumbai, Bandra Reclamation. I get 24 hours water. All the water that we get comes from five lakes in Thane, Adivasi area. And in those houses, there is no water piped connection at all. Bombay gets the water of the Adivasis. They go to death without water. It's their water, their lakes. Okay. So there is a transfer of water from poor to rich, from village to city. This is the way it's all going, right? So you have to look at where that water crisis. Okay, we went to the source of the river. Do you know that one of the biggest damage being done to rivers in this country is coming from religious tourism? Every river is considered sacred. I consider rivers sacred. Okay, because life comes from that river. Now, what do they do? They promote pilgrim tourism in the religious town. And so you know what they do? They marble and concrete the entire town, and the water has nowhere to go. So when the water comes in summer in small trickles, it dries up and you have drought. When the water comes in a big flow in winter, it hits the concrete and it floods. The Trimbakeshwar, the source town of Godavari. Old Mahabaleshwar, the source town of Krishna. You go and see. There isn't any water, any inch for the water to breathe. They've completely concreted these towns and done that. Yeah. So there are many, many reasons why you're having a crisis. You're having a serious climate change. Extreme episodes of erratic weather are growing. So I will stop there. I will say that you need to look at the processes that are the great processes of our time and understand them through the lives of people. Yeah. Thank you.